Well, South Dakota State, you can see how good they are offensively. Came out, start the game, and, you know, they can get going. And I felt like we gave effort, but they were making tough shots. And you know, the advantage of having that day off, you know, and that's why you want to finish first or second. You get that day off. Last night we were in a slugfest, and they came out fresh and played really well. For the team and for us, you know, the hardest thing you do, one of the hardest things you do as a coach is go in that locker room and see the guys after a game like this and the season, you know, losing a chance to go to the NCAA tournament and keep playing. But really proud. I knew our guys wouldn't quit. I mean, they haven't quit all year, and they fight. They're tough. They care about the team, and it says a lot about them and then our culture as a program and how much we've won. So we don't have any seniors. It's a little bit different, but couldn't be more. I told them I couldn't be more proud of the way they played this year and the things we've accomplished and how well we've played, and that I loved them, you know, they were broken up, but they did a great job this year. And State deserves, you know, what they get. They're very good. So
we'll open up for questions for the student athletes.
Michael McClure, Argus Leader. Kruz, is it tough to look at the big picture now coming off the loss, just, you know, with some of the positives that come out of the season?
Yeah, obviously. Coming out of that loss, you know, like you said, it is definitely hard. Looking at the big picture, but honestly, Coach said it best. I mean, we did more than we were expected of us. I think the guys hung around all season, all games. I think we never showed doubt that we didn't want to compete or anything like that. We were always competitive. This is a great group of guys. Can't say enough about everybody. So yeah.
Barry Poe, Sioux City Journal. Kruz, how much did last night take out of you guys? Not to make any excuses, but, you know, did that make a difference at all coming in tonight?
Honestly, I was fresh. I felt fresh coming into this. We did a good job of rolling out and watching film and doing what we needed to prepare in the short time that we did. And kudos to SDSU. I mean, they took it to us early, and that was the game.
Xavier, obviously you started the year in the starting lineup, and now you're kind of adjusting your new role. How did that sort of impact your development this season? And, you know, at what point do you feel like you are in your development because all that changed?
Like you said, it's just like Coach said, just know your role and stuff like that. And I feel like guys towards the end of the season, you know, got comfortable in their role and stuff like that. And just like I said, in practice, doing the reps and stuff like that, I think. Having me come off the bench and stuff like that, I thought that was a good move, and I think we've adjusted to that role, and I think we in this game, I think the adrenaline was running. I think we were fresh and stuff like that, but State's a good team, so they hit some tough shots, so they deserved it.
Sean Bauer, Kayla Sports, yeah, piggybacking off of that, Kruz, when you guys feel like you're in good position, you're playing good defense and they're hitting shots still. I mean, how is that frustrating? How does that kind of affect you guys?
I mean, definitely okay, like when they're hitting a couple, but then obviously the SDSU just keep doing it, you know, consistently throughout the half, throughout the whole game, honestly, and it is a little bit demoralizing. But like Coach said, we keep fighting, you know, we keep fighting. That's what this program does. We keep fighting until the last second, so yeah.
Zach Borg, Dakota News Now. Kruz, between the transfers and injuries, which dated back to last year, the COVID layoff, the start, this team had every reason to fall into an abyss, and you guys won 19 games. What do you look back on that just made this a successful season, and where do you take it coming back with pretty much the same roster and a few more players next year?
Yeah, no, we have the same guys. I mean, I love the season. This was a great season. Obviously, we did get 19 wins, so that's amazing for the program. We look forward to next season, so yeah.
Thanks, fellas. You can
thank
head
you
back to
the thank you.
Thanks, Coach.
right, go ahead with questions for Coach.
Todd, how did you kind of try to handle it when SDSU got off to that fast start? Because, you know, you want to call a timeout, but you also, the fans were such a factor. How did you sort of measure that?
Yeah, you know, you're always thinking that. You know, we battled for a few minutes. It was really tough for us because Tasso's picked up two fouls in the first couple minutes of the game. And even though, you know, they do a good job on him and they double him in the post, he is a very important part of what we do offensively. And he's one of the guys that people are now doubling. So now we create an advantage. And so when he picked up two fouls, that's big. And we run a lot of offense through him, whether it's at the high post or picking pops or punching him, getting the ball in the post. So that you know, you don't go into, you know, every game's different. You don't go into the game expecting that to happen. And all of a sudden now he's sitting. And then they, as you said, they make shots. You know, Wilson's hard to handle, obviously. Shireman can make shots if you're right with him or not, which is why he's so good. So, you know, you didn't want him to go on a big run, but that's what they do. They can get it going, and they shot 69% in the first half and 63% from the three. That's why they're the best 3-point shooting team in the country.
Obviously, there was a lot of unknowns to start the year, and then basically everything that could have changed did change. I guess, you know, how difficult of a task was this, just from a head coach's perspective?
Well, you know, I'll say this. At our level, it's really – AJ was, from last year, I would argue he's the best guard in the league. I mean, I believe that, you know, best player. He's probably MVP of the league last year if he doesn't get hurt. We didn't have him. He's in the locker room crying. He didn't play this year, you know, which type of kid he is. He's so upset. To go through, you know, at our level, it's hard to lose a player of that caliber. You just don't replace those guys, you know. And we dealt, obviously, with some adversity. X was out for 6 weeks during league, and we had some illness and, you know, playing games to make up games. And I thought our guys through the whole year were – it was unbelievable what we accomplished. I've told you guys this team has reached its potential more than any other team I've coached in 34 years. It's not even – I would say that without any doubt. You know, winning – I think we were – won 10 of our last 13, or probably 11 of our last 14. We swept the bottom five. And, you know, I couldn't be more proud of our guys. You know, they battled through a lot. And it's also unusual to pull a red shirt out in the middle of the year. We pulled Keaton out of red shirt because we didn't have enough guys to play. You know, he accepted whatever he got, and he's going to be a good player in our program, but that's very unusual, you know, to have to do that. But there are a lot of things we did this year that were a little bit unusual.
This question comes from Tim Hill of the Reaching the Summit podcast via Zoom. Tough situation for you at halftime. What did you say to the guys to create urgency without desperation?
Well, you try to break the game into 4 minutes, you know, first 4 minutes win it, which we did, but we didn't impact it enough. You know, I walked in there, our guys were talking to each other about, you know, they were coaching themselves. I know this group, you know, we got down at UMKC, a big margin, cut it all the way down to six. We don't get blown out really. I mean, we're not used to that. That UMKC and probably tonight, you know, and then maybe the first state game when we had the limited roster. But I knew we wouldn't quit. I was hoping that we could make a bigger dent and you know, win the first 4 minutes, win the second 4 minutes, but make a bigger dent. But state's really good. We ended up winning the second half by two, but we never really got close enough to make them, you know, nervous or where we could make a run and make a difference. But our guys didn't quit, and I knew that was not we weren't going to quit. So
I'm not sure, Coach, if you'd want to pursue any postseason opportunities, if there's a CBI or CIT, but obviously on paper you should have most of these guys back depending on whatever happens with the portal or whatnot. What needs to happen for them when the sting of this wears off? Where do you want them to just grow in the off season? Because obviously, with everybody coming back and AJ, the expectations will be pretty high.
Yeah. We'll talk to our administration. We've been invited to both all the tournaments, CVI, CIT, with a young group. You want to get them as much basketball as possible. And with everybody, no seniors on the roster, everybody, coming back or possibly coming back, and then you add AJ, I know that this program, next year, like you said, Zach, there'll be high expectations, and we will be very good. So, we'll talk to our administration about that. With COVID and everything that's gone on, foreign tours and different things, have been put on hold, and, but you want, we'll talk to our group and see how what their mindset is. They'd love to play basketball, and they're a young group, so that would be a possibility. But we definitely are looking forward to next year and getting AJ back, because AJ's our leader, our point guard, and you guys know how good of a player he is and what impact he makes. And you add him to this group and add a guy or two, and yeah, we'll be ready to go.